Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss 10 MCQs from your current affairs part, and we also discuss here also the explanation of those current affairs. So today is 14th September, so let's see what are the questions for the today. So the first question is, consider the following organization treaties. First, UNHRC, second UNESCO, third INF treaty, fourth JCPOA. Which of the above organization treaties US is not a part of it recently? So friends, let me tell you that this question has been asked because these organizations have been seen in news for quite a long time now, as of now. So US, we have to choose that which treaty US is not part. So let me tell you friends that from all those treaties US has withdrawn itself. So answer is D, that is none of the above. So US is part of none. So from United Nations Human Rights Commission, withdrawn because of the concern that it says that it is biased against Israeli people. So then intermediate nuclear forces treaty also, which was there between Russia and USA, it was withdrawn by the US unilaterally. And then JCPOA, that is your nuclear deal that is between Iran and US and its allied its allies. So in this treaty also the US has withdrawn from its obligation. So the answer is D, none of the above. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Kartarpur Sahib Pilgrim Corridor. First, the corridor will connect Gurdwara Darbar Sahib in India's Gurdaspur district with Dera Baba Nanak Shrine in Pakistan's Kartarpur. Second, the corridor will be constructed above the river Ravi. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that first statement is incorrect because this Gurdwara Darbar Sahib is not in Gurdaspur district, rather Gurdwara Darbar Sahib is in Amritsar district. So first is incorrect, second is you are correct. Yes, corridor will be constructed above the river Ravi. So solution is B, that is second only. So Kartarpur Sahib corridor, it is also dubbed as road to peace. So it will connect Gurdwara Darbar Sahib in Pakistan's Kartarpur with Dera Baba Nanak Shrine in India's Gurdaspur district. So you might say that Gurdwara Darbar Sahib, as I am saying that Gurdwara Darbar Sahib is in Amritsar district, but here it is saying that the explanation is saying that it is in Pakistan. So yes friends, there are two Gurdwaras, Gurdwara Darbar Sahibs. So there is one in Pakistan, and there is also one in Amritsar, which is also famous by the name Golden Temple. So that is there in Amritsar. So it is constructed to allow visa free access to pilgrims from India. So its implementation is basically integrated development project with the Government of India funding to provide smooth and easy passage with all the modern amenities. So shrine and its significance is basically it stands at the bank of river Ravi, on the bank of river Ravi, 120 km northeast of Lahore, and it was here that Guru Nanak assembled a Sikh community and lived for 18 years until his death in 1539. So shrine is visible from the Indian side, as Pakistani authorities generally trim the elephant grass that would otherwise obstruct the view. So Indian Sikhs gather in large numbers for the darshan from the Indian side, and binoculars are installed at the Gurdwara Dera Baba Nanak. So this is your explanation of your second question. And next is third question. Consider the following statements. First, National Investigation is a federal agency responsible for terrorism related investigation. Second, NetGrid was set up in the aftermath of 26/11 terror attack to collate the intelligence related to terrorism related activities. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct, because this National Investigation Agency is a federal, here the word is missing, agency is missing. So it is a basically federal agency responsible for anti-terrorism, and NetGrid was basically set up after the aftermath of 26/11. So national intelligence grid. So project wants to link social media accounts to the huge data base of records related to immigration, entry and exit, banking and telephone details, among others. So NetGrid is basically a counter-terrorism program. So it utilizes technologies like big data and analytics to study and analyze the huge amounts of data from various intelligence and enforcement agencies to help track suspected terrorists and prevent terrorist attacks. So it will connect in different phases data providing organizations and users. So who can access the data? The database would be accessible to the authorized persons from 11 agencies on a case-to-case basis, and only for professional investigations into suspected cases of terrorism. So criticisms are basically that it may lead to violation of privacy and leak of confidential personal information, and it is also questioned that given that no state agency or police force has access to its database, thus reducing the chances of immediate effective action. And also few experts say that digital databases such as NetGrid can be misused. So over the last two decades, the very digital tools that terrorists use have also become great weapons to fight the ideologies of violence. So intelligence agencies have also opposed amid fears that it would impinge on their territory and possibly results in leaks on the leads they were working on to other agencies. So this is about your third question. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Pradhan Mantri Kisan Mandhan Yojana. First, the scheme covers all the farmers who are practicing farming. Second, the Life Insurance Corporation of India is the implementing agency of the scheme. So this question is basically a repetition. So here you might be knowing its answer if you are seeing our video regularly. So friends, first statement is wrong because it is not available to all the farmers, but rather it is available to small and marginal farmers. So Life Insurance Corporation of India is the implementing agency. So only one statement is correct, that is second one. So the answer is B. So salient features are that it is a voluntary contribution for farmers in the entry group of 18 to 40 years. So monthly pension of 3000 will be provided. So farmers will have to make a monthly contribution from rupees 55 to rupees 200. So central government will also make an equal contribution. So spouse is also eligible to get a separate pension of 3000 upon making separate contributions to the fund. So Life Insurance Corporation of India shall be the pension fund manager. So in case of death of the farmer before retirement age, the spouse may continue in the scheme. So total contribution made by the farmer along with interest will be paid to the spouse. So friends, let me tell you that one thing that I have said, that it is available to small and marginal farmers, it is wrong. It is not just available to small and marginal farmers, rather it is available to almost all the farmers between the age group of 18 to 40 years. So the exclusive age is 18 to 40 years. So the farmers below 18 years of age or above 40 years of age cannot avail themselves of this benefit. So this is not the case that it is only available to small and marginal farmers. So sorry for the wrong statement that was earlier given by me. Next is, which of the following statement is correct? Pradhan Mantri Khanij Kshetra Kalyan Yojana is a news program meant to provide for the welfare of areas and people affected by mining related operations using the funds generated by the District Mineral Foundation. Second is, the Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Amendment Act 2015 mandated the setting up of District Mineral Foundations in all districts in the country affected by mining related operations. The funds will be used to implement the above scheme. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements is correct. So the answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So Pradhan Mantri Khanij Kshetra Kalyan Yojana, it was seen in news. So article discusses in detail about this scheme, that important features are, it is basically to implement various developmental and welfare projects and programs in mining affected areas. So this is about in detail explanation, so you can read it in detail by getting access to the PDFs. So it will not be kind of, we can say, prudent in the context of time that we discuss the entire scheme here. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, Rohingya refugees seen in news belongs to which country? So you have to tell this the answer of this. So this answer is quite easy. So the options are Myanmar, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Indonesia. So friends, the answer is sorry friends, the answer is A, that is Myanmar. So Rohingyas are basically ethnic group, mostly Muslim, that are basically the residents of the Rakhine state of Myanmar. So ethnically they are much closer to Indo-Aryan people of India and Bangladesh than to Sino-Tibetans of the country. Next is Maitri 2019 is a military exercise between A. India-Thailand, B. India-Singapore, C. India-Malaysia, D. None of the above. So let me tell you friends that the answer is India-Thailand. So Maitri is a basically military exercise between these two countries. And it is annual training event, so it is conducted alternatively in Thailand and India since 2006. So this 2019 edition was held in Meghalaya. So aim is to share experience gained during various counter-terrorism operations in their respective countries. Next is Rudrashila, seen in news is related to A. Water rafting, B. River known for frequent flooding, C. Highest mountain peak, D. None of the above. So friends, the answer is A, that is water rafting. So Rudrashila is basically a white water rafting expedition being undertaken by Kalidhar battalion under the aegis of Battle Axe Division. So it has been organized to commemorate the 75th raising day of the Kalidhar battalion. Rudrashila one takes its name from the name Rudraprayag, tributary of the Ganges river in the mountains of the Uttarakhand. Next is, consider the following statements related to Pangongso lake. First, the line of actual control between India and Pakistan cuts through the lake. Second, it is a saltwater lake. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that first statement is clearly wrong, because line of actual control is not there between India and Pakistan. It is between India and China. So, but yes, second statement is correct. So the answer would be B, that is second only. So Indian and Chinese armies recently clashed along the Pangong Lake in Ladakh. So it is a 135 kilometer long lake located in the Himalayas at the height of approximately 4,350 meters, stretches out from India to China. So it is formed from Tethys geosyncline, and it is a saltwater lake, and it has strategic significance because in by itself lake does not have major tactical significance, but it lies at the path of Chushul approach, one of the main approaches that China can use for an offensive into Indian held territory. So this is about your ninth question, and let's move on to the next question. Next is drought toolbox, seen in news is related to A. physical box to check out drought prone soils, B. digital platform to help drought related problems, C. measuring instrument, D. none of the above. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So let me tell you friends that the answer is B, that is digital platform to help drought related problems. So drought toolbox, it is context is that the ongoing 14th conference of parties to United Nations Convention to combat desertification, a drought toolbox has been launched. So it is basically a kind of knowledge bank that may be used by vulnerable countries such as India to reduce drought risk and be better prepared and effectively respond to it. So the more in more you can read about, if you want to read in detail, then you can pause the video and can read in detail. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about current affair MCQs. So if you like this video, if you like the discussion, if it in case help you people, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And lastly friends, let me tell you that we also have a Telegram channel on which we regularly post updates relating to various initiatives that are undertaken by us. So if in case you are willing to remain in touch with our initiatives and our updates, then do ensure that you join our public Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and it will also be provided there in the description box. So friends, this is all about today's video. If you have any doubts, if you have any queries, you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.